As a commentator, of course, I have to trust in the analytical opinion of my co-caster here, LBZS, as well, because I have no idea what I'm talking about.
It will be fire for LBZS then. Alrighty, Lacoste and Black, take it away into our viewers. I'm sorry for what's about to happen.
It's going to be great. It's going to be super good.
I can feel it. Like, not the two casters you expected to cast this series, but
or maybe
here
you
we
did.
Are.
Here maybe
we are.
You did.
You probably did, you know. You're watching this tournament. Why are these two best analysts not casting together? One of them also has a bright future in play-by-play if he wants to do it. So, yeah, we'll see how it goes.
Yeah. Which one was that?
We'll have to see.
I will have to see.
I'm not sure who is it yet, but one of us probably will end up, you know, his career as a play-by-play caster. He's like, yeah, this analytical stuff is not for me.
Yeah, it would make sense because we're both really good at it, as we're about to showcase. Is there going to be a stun on the gyrocopter? Nope. Just looking at each other, and two bounty runes each. Not what we expect. Like, usually in SEA, there's five-man smokes, you know, on both sides, and first blood, pre-30 seconds. Chinese team's a little bit more conservative.
They're starting with the three heroes on the top lane. They want to get the first blood. Let's see how that's going to work out.
It's a pretty good combo, right? Stun into Arctic Burn into Thunder Strike. Who's the best target? Probably the Io.
Yeah. I have to agree. Kaz has to be careful. He planted down an observer ward, so that's going to scout things out. You see, my play-by-play already with some mistakes.
It's all right. That's what we're here for. But how are we sort of like expecting the lanes to play out? I mean, Winter Wyvern is still waiting here. Kind of wasting his time. Yeah, wasting his time big time.
And just pretend you're not there. Like, you're AFK. They're still going to go for it. Shylock.
I mean, if he dies here, that would be a pretty big blunder.
Here comes Rubick. Three-man fade bolt. Xiaofun, a lot of trouble. One more hit. We'll do the trick. And that's the first blood for MagMA.
All right, that turned around. Why would they just go there and take so much damage and stuff? It was really
uncoordinated. It was a big bait from MagMA. They're like, yeah, you guys are sitting on a ward. We'll TP in Rubick. So that leaves Nightstalker on the bottom lane against the Centaur, which I really like. Like, Nightstalker, hero that has high armor sitting at 8 when he's near the tower, HP regen 7.1. So he's like, yeah, I'm good to go, you know? I don't want to make any aggressive rotations anyway during the daytime, so I'll just get some levels, which I really like what MagMA is doing.
That's
so
probably the best-case scenario for them, because he doesn't lane very well against Wraith King, right? So they got away with a lot, I feel, here. Also, the tri-lane, who do you give the advantage to? Rubick, Arctic Burn, Thunderstrike follow-up. They do have a Glimpse follow-up if they need it. 5 Magic Stick charges, though, and Io's in to the rescue. And they're probably going to win this fight, too. Dire got to run.
Yeah, it's too much healing coming out. Also, I'm not a big fan of a glimpse in a tri lane. I would prefer if they put the point in kinetic field.
Yeah.
Not sure how you feel about it.
I think that is very true, especially with the splinter blast. You want to just keep them in there, be able to spam them out of lane. Glimpse doesn't really add anything. More like if you're 3 versus 2, it makes a lot more sense.
Sure. Because your like chase potential is much better, and you can get away with that. But for now, I think you just want to keep them in place. So MagMA, they pull the lane to the side camp. Let's see if Rubick decides to fade bolt it. Of course he does. That's what he does best. Kill steal, enough. Creeps and heroes.
Yep. And we see initiation on Rubick here. Arctic Burn. Wraith King stun as well. Glimpse back.
Okay.
Easy kill, but Wraith King in trouble here. Nah, he should be fine. Do they have a healing cell for him? They do. Good kill. What Trident is stronger, do you think? Is it Dire or Radiant in this case? If it's like three full HP heroes clashing.
Like, if three heroes get hit by a Fade Bolt, Fade Bolt right now is a percent damage reduction, which is not that great in a Trilance. If it was an old Rubick, I would say MagMA. But it's hard now, Wraith King hit level 2. Some Skelly Bros are gonna help out. So level 2 in the Vampiric Spirit. Vamp Spirit,
yes. DP actually pressuring OD quite a lot.
Oh my god, what is that? We didn't even talk about the mid lane.
Yeah.
How's that possible? You as a mid lane expert? That should not be happening, right?
That should not be happening for sure. I think he got outlasted quite a bit. I was busy looking at the action, of course. Maybe so was the OD, because it doesn't look like he was really last hitting creeps. Winter Wyvern and Disruptor running towards the Minotaur rune, just a 4-hero brawl on the top rune. Ayo ends up picking it up. Arctic Burn over the cliff to get out. Good Harris damage. And Centaur skipping creeps. Do you like that decision?
Sure. I mean, he can pressure the Nightstalker, even though he is Lord of the Rings with his build. Two Ring of Regen, Ring of Health, so he can drag the creep wave and just get some extra farm. Nightstalker should probably be doing the same thing, right?
Yeah, put it to the big camp.
Exactly.
I'm not sure why he's just fine with being, you know, inefficient.
You're getting so much less farm than the Centaur right now.
Yeah, for sure. And the Centaur ult, of course, is a huge help for the tri-lane too, which is going to be online. And just one more creep wave. I'm a little bit worried about his Odie, though. He's really getting pressured a lot. He's probably going to be fine with the Ring of Health, but not expect him to lose to DP like that. Doubling the CS is a big deal. Nightstalker is running for the bounty runes, which means... Oh. Wow, Ayo getting initiated. I didn't even see that. Wow, he got blown up by level 2 Thunderstrike. DP rotation, easy wave to get the kill on the Disruptor. No problem. 3 bounty runes secured for Radiant as well. Already up 1k gold. Mostly because of that mid lane. There's a 1k gold difference.
It's a huge difference on a mid lane, but once OD gets that meteor hammer, one rotation, and that Prophet should be dead, right?
Yeah, probably, but at the same time, I feel like if this Nightstalker can rotate middle, maybe with a silence, with a DP ult, it could also kill the OD and pressure the tower, maybe.
You don't want to rotate as a Nightstalker with just by walking. You need a TP rotation, because yeah. Like at the bottom lane, you see a hero missing, you know something's happening.
Yeah, I mean, especially the Centaur, the Vanguard now, super tanky, no way you can bring him down.
I want to see the usage of that ulti on the top lane, get a kill, because look at where the lane is standing. Like, MagMA is very close to the enemy tier 1 tower.
Disruptor actually rotating bottom, going on the Nightstalker here, Centaur ult activated. Storm, they don't have the damage, it's just a feed! Lifted into the tower, glimpse back, he has another void in 3 seconds. Thunderstrike and cooldown.
Oh, they're going in. DZY, one more void. Like, he should be able to survive through the
Thunderstrike.
Nah, he's fine. The regen will
kick one
in.
More take. No, he's gonna do that. He's gonna be dead. Oh!
Unfortunately, Rubick could not do anything about it.
Yeah, DP rotated top using a regen rune as well to just tank up the tower. And it's a super early DP tower push.
Like, this is
bottom Rubick.
Okay,
and trouble. Yes.
Drop the hammer. You have 2 hammers pretty soon once you finish the meteor hammer. But the top tier 1 tower has fallen for LBZS. Like, catch you on Wyvern. This is a place where you want to be with Wyvern most of the time. You know, just using that Splinter Blast, but not when you're level 2. You know, it doesn't do that much.
Yeah, and it was probably a better trade for the Radiant, even though they lost 2 towers. Losing that tower really early is a big problem for here, like Wraith King, who just wants to jungle.
Remember, this is only a Nightstalker's safe lane, but, you know, he's still an offlaner in this game, which means that he's going for the pretty standard item build on the Nightstalker, just getting that Blink Dagger into BKB, and most of the time it's a nullifier, but you can still swap things around. You want to be able to jump the back lines, find Disruptor, mostly find Vyvern so he can't split the fight with the Winter's Curse.
Meteor Hammer into... Oh, he's just using it on the tower. They don't even try to set up for a kill. Interesting. Centaur taking a lot of damage here, Rubick rotating in. But they don't have DP ult, so probably not too much happening, right?
Yeah, I was thinking about the Centaur the other day, like, why is this hero not picked? My biggest problem with the hero is, like, what do you buy? What do you buy on the hero?
Yeah,
like,
apparently Vanguard doesn't do anything.
Like, you buy Vanguard, you buy Hood, you get a Blink Dagger, like, but what do you buy after? Like, Heaven's Halberd doesn't feel that great anymore. Maybe like a Lotus Orb, but still feels
taking a lot of damage
weak.
Here. One more Void. Level 4 Void up. Maybe he decides to use ult as well, yep. Centaur also using ult. No lift, and he should just be fine. Winter Wyvern rotating in as well. Trading ult cooldowns. Who do you think that benefits, or is just an even trade?
I mean, they use Centaur ulti, so they can't use it defensively to save the other heroes. I want to see some kind of rotation on a mid lane. OD. With the Meteor Hammer set up, but there's still tier 1 tower standing, so probably just gonna go in the jungle, get some farm there.
Yeah, DP is massive, almost has a heals completed, only needs Aetheron Gold for that. I would have loved to just see the Nightstalker rotate middle together with that Exorcism, you know, on the OD, just pressure that tower.
I think Nightstalker is making a mistake where he feels comfortable because his lane is always at his tower. So he's like, I'm good, bro. You know, I want to farm. But he should be rotating a bit more. Yeah. It's nighttime. Let your supports get the level 6 on the bottom, possibly Rubick.
Mm-hmm. He's adopting that like carry mentality.
Yeah, exactly.
Which is not good if you're an offlane player. You should never be falling into that trap. Bot tower, Sand tower is just going to be pressuring the tower with return. Should be a pretty easy takedown. And DP is probably going to use ult mid lane. Yep. Three-man rotation as well. How are they going to defend it? They're not in position at all.
Yeah, they don't have the good heroes to defend the tower with Xiao Fu in a lot of trouble. Only level 4 on that disruptor. Just gets blown up by a void.
Easy
and
kill.
And Crypt Swarm.
Winter Wyvern rotating in though. Might be able to defend and delay a little bit with a Splinter Blast. Doing just that. And Odie's here too. No nighttime. 5 seconds.
No points in ulti as well. Pretty surprised he popped that ulti during the nighttime.
Oh, banish on the DP. Oh, nice. Lift by the Rubick.
But
good
the
silence follow up. Wow, that was so clutch by
the
Rubick and DP both. Really well played there by MagMA. Who are now
no
up
casualties.
1k still. Yeah. DP ult used. Mid tower still standing. Winter Wyvern close to level 6, and Nightstalker TPing back to farm, which now makes more sense because it's daytime, I don't care too much, and Gyrocopter has not been pressured at all, and neither has Wraith King. They're both just free farming, sitting neck and neck and net worth. He's going Armlet, do you like that on Wraith King?
I've seen some Armlet in European games. I'm still a bigger fan of Midas Radiance or just the gloves into Radiance. Radiance feels so busted. Yep. Well, maybe he feels, you know, Radiant's miss chance is not going to do that much against the heroes, but...
It's just the damage it gives, right?
Damage over time just feels insanely good.
Yeah.
8 Skellybros on a Raid King should probably use it.
Yeah, ODTP'd bottom to set up for a kill after a failed smoke gank top. If he gets that banish, it should be a free kill. Centaur should start moving soon, though. What is that communication? No communication. But they're sitting on a ward.
Yeah, I don't think you need to get face boots on a centaur. Like after having a Vanguard, two Ring of Regions, you're just laying your Blink Dagger.
Yeah, he's slowing his game down a lot, it feels like. And we'll see if that is gonna become an issue later in the game.
Oh, chipped vest, man. This time around, I'd say this is a really good pickup. On Axe, on a centaur, on a Legion Commander, it looks okay-ish.
Yeah.
But on any other hero, it's probably the worst item in the game.
Yeah.
It doesn't even give that much HP region. It's 3.5. I want to see armor coming out from that item. It's a vest.
How much?
Like two?
Two?
Two. I don't think it would be too much.
How about the 2.5?
2.5.
To match the HP region, which
is
3.5.
Best I can do is two.
Two? Okay. 3.5 HP region.
Usually
two and
how
and half
it
armor.
Works, someone says a number like, yeah, 150. Sorry, bro. Best I can do is like 11.
Yeah. I know what you mean. But sometimes, you know, they go way overboard with the numbers as well. And then you end up with like a 1400 damage Hoodwing ult. Hmm. Oh, wait. It's still in the game.
Hoodwing, very fun hero. When,
yeah.
You know the feeling that I have whenever I have Hoodwink in my team is like she's not doing great, but if it's on the enemy team, I just get one-shotted.
All the time, yeah. I know how you feel. Farming an ancient stack here on a Gyrocopter, he doesn't have the most damage, so it's going to take a little while. And Wyvern smoked up by himself. Interesting.
Solo smoke?
For what?
No wards?
Yeah.
Probably misclick.
Yeah, must have been. Splinter Blast. Going for Adelance first on Wyvern. Do you like that? Do you prefer a Blink Dagger? Or?
He's playing a 4 here, so I'm kind of okay with that. Just trying to stay a bit further away from the fights, from the silences, Nightstalker, and the DP could be a bit problematic. You're still going to be in trouble, you know, playing into Nightstalker Radiant's with a Blink Dagger. So, like, you're going to be the primarily target. I hate playing these heroes when everyone just wants to kill you first.
Yeah, definitely, especially against the Nightstalker. Big smoke up here. DP ult up, Blink Dagger picked up, and Nighttime ready as well. Like, don't you think? I feel really weird for LBZS. They're like not trying to pressure at all during daytime.
Like they should be more active for sure. Also, Xiao Fu, his build on Disruptor, it's like, man, I don't even know what my spells do. I'll just, you know, put 2 points in this, put 2 points in Glimpse. Like, yeah, Kinetic Field, yeah, no, let's just make it look good. I have 2 points in Kinetic Field at this point, just don't feel good at all.
Yep, he stole the Astral. We all know what happens from now on. Well, not really, because he's only level 7. Only one level in passive. DP picking up the region rune. Doesn't get astraled. I mean, at least use your spells or do something. Interesting decision. I feel like LBZS is really timid. I'm not sure why they're so afraid of taking any fight. The Wraith King has
Wraith
armor.
His armor. Yeah, you know,
which is like what he wants.
Exactly. Like, you get the armor, you didn't buy armor to just farm. You want to fight with a team. Like, if you didn't want to fight, get that Radiance going, have a bit delayed timing. But they are missing onto something. Disruptor ulti is up, Centaur getting very close to his Blink Dagger. Like, if he didn't buy that Phase Boots, would have a Blink Dagger. So it's all about this synergy, you know, what timing are you looking for?
Feels like they're very off timing with each other. He finishes Armlet, but he still needs like 800 for his Blink. And just overall, they haven't really used their ult. There has no there has been no Wyvern ult, no Disruptor ult.
Well, when you are, like, missing the timings when you're playing, are you like, man, I'm too farmed so the rest of the team can't keep up? You know, I have one extra item. Like, yeah. we missed our timing. I'm too farmed.
Yeah, I mean, I guess he won't be feeling too bad about that, but it just feels weird to, like, not be trying to use your big power spikes, which they really haven't tried at all. They're
and
just
now
fine
it's
farming.
A nighttime.
Yep.
They should definitely try to go for a fight. That Prophet ulti is level 1. This is something I always talk about. Spirit 8. Once you get to level 2, it's 16. So quite a big difference.
Yeah. Doubles up right away. Definitely a big power spike there.
Nightstalker hits OD. In, gets astral. Let's see. Is there a Static Storm? Just a Meteor Hammer. Good silence on the Raid King and Disruptor. But the stolen astral. Keeping him alive. You go, Black.
Yeah, jumping in on the DP here. Wraith King absolutely demolishing her. Winter's Curse on the Nightstalker.
Oh, that's a good setup, but no kinetic field follow-up.
What an IO with the save on the Gyrocopter. Of course, he will be teleporting back in. No, huh? He really kind of top from top to middle and saved him back top. What is that kind of play? I didn't even expect it at all. So he is safe. The DP just got blown up. Like, he did nothing.
Yep, no ulti, Centaur, his aim,
another
ulti
Astral.
Illusions.
Yeah. Okay. Oh, that was Rubik's Astral, okay.
It's hard to keep track, you know, who's using these Astrals.
It really
we
is.
Played a game the other day, Rubik against the OD, and it felt, you know, really good for the Rubik.
It did. So, back to farming it is, I guess. Both teams kind of looking at each other. DP died. And, oh. Jumping in on the OD again with Crippling Fear. Slow. He has an Astral Imprisonment if needed. Rubik getting Astral himself. Another Void available. And it should
Rocket
just be a dead
him.
OD.
There's no rotation, so yeah. OD will fall.
This Nightstalker's putting on a lot of pressure. I like that a lot.
Nightstalker's playing well.
Yep. DP still trying to get his level 12. Very hesitant to use his ult. You know, probably because it's level 1, I'm so close to 12, I don't really want to use it. But it's better than not using it at all, my friend. Wraith King still farming. He now finishes Desolator. He's going to absolutely destroy this DP, who is sitting at 6 armor. It's going to go to like 0. Going to take full 700 damage.
Oh man, Wraith King is going to hurt quite a lot. They need to fight with the Wraith King. Like, he's super strong, level 2 ulti.
Yep.
One thing they can't do is like try to commit, because all Rubik wants to steal pretty much in this game is either Astral, or if you have like Astral, then you use Winter's Curse, possibly steal Astral once again. So for LBZS, their primary target is try to take out Rubik, especially if he has a stolen imprisonment.
Yeah. DP ping bottom to just farm. I thought they were going to use Exorcism to get hit to tower top, but they're so scared to fight, even though it's nighttime. Maybe a little bit scared here.
Nightstalker blinks in.
Yeah.
We're not touching each other. No fighting.
They're very,
them off. Yeah.
Yeah, they're very pacifist, both teams. They just kind of want to farm and look at each other. I expected a lot more kills with these two aggressive lineups coming out, but everyone's just fine farming their core items. OD going into BKB, DP going into BKB, Nightstalker going into the BKB. Gyrocopter going to BKB.
There's like, what, 1, 2, 3, 4 BKBs being built right now?
Yeah, and 3 on the side of MagMA.
There's no abilities that like go through magic immunity. Wraith King right clicks, that's the biggest one. Winter's Curse, but yeah, I don't think you care too much about it. Their physical damage output on the curse is not that big. Like, if you don't use it on, let's say, someone close to the gyrocopter, and Gyro, man, he has the Fuels of Blade queued up. I'm having some TI-8 flashbacks.
I really hope he doesn't go through with it, because, of course, you just count that by buying a 1400 item. Yeah, nothing. Initiation on Rubick here. Astraling, the enemy OD. DP in trouble here. Yules on cooldown, another double edge. Centaur ult, DP dead. Can Rubick make it out? Oh, they used OD ult to kill the Rubick, but it wasn't enough damage. He has too much instolen, or too much mana stolen. Because he astraled the OD, he's sitting at more max mana than the OD, so he just healed him with it.
That's not possible.
It's not possible.
But would be cool if it worked that way.
It should work that way.
Yeah, can't wait to use my spell to actually heal enemy.
I actually can't believe he has 400 less mana than Rubick, though. That is very interesting. Nightstalker ult popped, going on the Centaur here. Defensive Astral by the OD. Nightstalker still looking to kill the Centaur. He just blinks out. Easy. They have to be careful. We're fighting with his Wraith King. Rubick taking a lot of damage on the back line from the Winter Wyvern. Nightstalker on top of the Winter.
Play by play. Keep it going, Black.
Gyrocopter with a BKB, and another defensive Astral. Yeah, Nightstalker on the back line on the Winter Wyvern. In trouble here on the Winter Wyvern. DP ult popped in the back line, running in. Silence on three.
Right clicks.
A lot of damage from the Wraith King and Odie coming in here. Odie in trouble now, Astraling the DP. Another great Astral, and they're just gonna disengage.
Man, these fights, no one's dying, because everyone has Astral. Okay, you focus me, I'm just gonna pop the Astral on the hero, then the Rubick does the same thing.
Let's
change things up. All right, let's try to smoke up, find Rubick, kill him, and now you know there's no Dead Prophet ulti, so it's a possibility for LBZS to actually go and take the mid tier 1 tower, or
Blink.
Just...
But nothing.
Nice
glimpse
reactions
back.
At the glimpse. He just wanted the vision.
But he astraled him. And now a defensive astral. Great ability. But the mid tower should be pretty free. Lift.
I think they force a fight inside the pit.
Glimpse in two. This Rubick might be in trouble, but he has another astral ready. No DP ult. BKB back up on Gyrocopter. Wraith King very low, only sitting at 500 health. Stunning
Stun,
the Gyrocopter.
Just kidding, needs to fall back. This should
Spirit
take him
siphon.
Down, but the good toggle.
Good toggle.
Oh,
BKB used.
All right. I mean,
very premature.
You know you can dodge it. You don't have to show it off. You know, you're not getting any value from this. And the glimpse back. These fights, man, no one's just dying. Like glimpses, astrals, everyone pops a BKB whenever they feel even a bit threatened.
Yeah. Gyrocopter picked up the Aghanim Scepter. I really hope he does not go for the Diffusal. I feel like it doesn't really make much sense. Just itemize into normal items. You know, Butterfly, this game looks amazing. Like, just go normal items. Don't be flashy.
It really does. Maybe he's thinking, you know, I'll burn Wraith's mana once. I'll make him invest gold into Shard. I can burn mana on the Cold Embrace target.
But you're investing like double the gold.
I know. Like, I'm just trying to find some
reasoning.
Sense in it.
Yes, I know. You're doing your job. It's what you paid for.
What are you paid for? Like, yeah, this build is so stupid. Really.
Well, I'm here to call people out on their mistakes, of course, as a good play-by-play caster should.
No, I'm really impressed by your play-by-play skills.
All right, another glimpse on the Gyrocopter. He has BKB available. Might have to pop it soon. Odie, of course, in pure damage.
Meteor Hammer.
Frame perfect.
Nope.
Not at all. And Gyrocopter.
Not even close.
Yep. And Gyrocopter ult expended. Glimpse up in 5 seconds.
Available. Let's go.
Nice. Silencing on 4. Centaur running in, getting silenced. OD with the right click. Big OD ult, which does absolutely nothing. Centaur in trouble here. DP doesn't have mana for ult. Nightstalker hitting the OD. OD also falling. Nightstalker with his BKB is way too strong. Another Astral on
DP
the Wraith King.
But she will get glimpse back. Let me take over. Yep. Nightstalker still chasing, blinking in with the crippling fear, controlling enemy units. And let's see if they have anything to stop the DP with. They don't. Cat you in a bit of a trouble. He's flying over. Nightstalker lost his flying ability, so needs to fall back. Good fight from MagMA. And good play-by-play by me. Like, I was really impressed with what I've just done.
You did amazingly there after you took over. I was, you know, catching my breath because I can't talk that much. I don't know how people do it. I was running out of steam,
see,
dude.
You know, running out of breath. You're like showing me with hands. Dude, please help me out.
I'm turning
like
red like a tomato. Thank you very much. You can see here in the replay. It all started with a seemed like to be a wasted BKB on Gyrocopter, but it turned out really well because the Nightstalker jumped in sound
for... Nightstalker is the MVP of that fight. Like, yeah. Look at him jump right now. They're all grouping up. Also, they have a vision, which is really important. Vision wins the games.
Odi ult does nothing.
It really does nothing. I mean, they're fighting in three BKBs, so it's really hard.
Yeah. Nightstalker pummeling. The OD.
5k gold lead for them. So yeah, we talked about the Nightstalker item build. He's going into Blink, into BKB, and getting that Nullifier. So that's going to be really, really big. Something I really don't like. I think I tried it a couple of times. It just feels so underwhelming. Winter Wyvern going for the Witchblade. Yeah, you're playing that position for that item does absolutely nothing.
Especially second item. After.
So you're going to have that 25 minutes in. They have BKBs. It's dispellable. Yeah. Just doesn't feel right.
Much rather see a Blink Dagger probably. Or just some sort to get away from that Nightstalker, who's always going to be on top of you at this point.
Yeah, like Glimmer Cape is fine. Blink Dagger is also fine. So you can just reset the fight. Make them waste their BKBs.
Yep. Bottom Bounty Rune, it should be a 3-2 split for the Radiant. Astral, nope, not in range. And 5k ahead now on the side of MagMA. DP going into Lincoln Sphere rather than Shivas, do you like that?
Let me just think about it. Yeah, good against Curse, good against Glimpse, possibly OD Astral. So, yeah, but maybe I would like more a casual plate mail just to be safe against the Raid King because your armor is at zero.
Yeah, when he hits you, you're done. Smoke here. Rave King and Rubik smoked up. Jumping in on the Disruptor. Center ult popped defensively. Nightstalker still flying after him. Another 3 seconds left on his BKB. Good Winter's Embrace, or Cold Embrace rather. Winter's Curse on three in the backline.
Cold Curse in the backline. Three-man stomp with the Meteor Hammer. They're taking over. Big Hammer from the OD. Dust dropping very low, and they will be able to bring it down. Shylock still standing his ground, trying to make something happen. Yule Scepter. Nope. Okay.
Stun.
He's just dead, man. Those right clicks. Relocate him out. Wow.
Good save from the Io there.
Yeah, Io's like, bro, I got you, but I will pay with my life this time.
Is it high ground or low ground, Ray? Is there?
It's low ground. It's low ground.
Oh, low ground. Okay. Yeah, this DP. He just died to Wraith King right click.
Oh, high? That's low ground.
No, like, for me, it looked like on the high ground. It was like on the cusp there. Whatever. Thank you for clarifying. For all the
so big
the
fight,
packs out there.
Like Nightstalker went in a bit too early, in my opinion.
Yeah,
you know,
very
disconnected from the team. Yes, you're speedy enough. We're gonna see that one again. So good curse, like they use the three-man stomp. Gyro without an IO feels very underwhelming.
Yeah, definitely. Also, 200 gold needed to finish a Scotty. We really need to see a casual plate. He goes away from the Lincolns into the Shiva's Guard. I liked it a lot more. If he had a plate mail there, I think they win that fight, to be honest.
Radiant I personally would get a plate mail, maybe into Lincoln Sphere, but yeah. I mean, Shiva's Guard is also fine.
Yeah, it's so. Just really good against Odie, removing or reducing his attack speed. Nightstalker jumping in on top of the Disruptor again. Crimson Guard popped defensively to help him again. Not a lot of damage coming out from the Nightstalker here. Steals the Centaur ult. Nice steal from the Rubik there. It's a very good tool to have
it's a very good Ruby game to start with. There's so many good spells to steal this game, like Winter's Curse, Cold Embrace. Most of the time, you just want that Astral.
But they're doing Roshan. Are they going to get it for free? Does Daya even know? They don't look like they know.
There's no vision. They only have one Observe Ward in the mid lane, which doesn't reveal anything. So yeah, Shylock, he decided to get that Scotty. No shenanigans. I do not want to get the Defusal Blade. Good choice.
Yep, he also has the same mana pool as Odie now, which means he takes zero damage from the whatever it's called. Sanity's Eclipse.
Winter's Embrace and
Winter's
the
Embrace,
Cold Curse.
Cold Curse, yeah. I'm getting a little confused there sometimes. But it's alright, because we don't speak English very well here. We're trying our best for you guys in Twitch chat. I hope you appreciate our efforts.
You know, it doesn't get better than this.
Yeah,
you know?
This is pretty much
see,
peak performance.
I've been practicing in our green room, asking Nomad, asking B-Cop, like, how do I improve? How do I talk faster? They say, like, you need to say 10 words per second. Like, I'm Bro, at best I can do is two. Okay, Rubick uses that Stampede.
Getting
Let's see.
Back.
Night Stalker already popped that BKB. Gyrocopter's in. Good curse, but that's not going to keep him alive. Io should be careful. One more right click from the... Oh, the stolen curse on Wraith King, but in the back lines. Night Stalker once again, he goes in. Big silence on a couple of the heroes. They need to fall back. It's not looking good. Imprisonment just to keep him alive a bit longer, but MagMA, they have this fight.
Easily. DP way too strong. If she doesn't get focused immediately, the DP ult doing a lot of damage. Night Stalker. I don't know why they glimpsed back to Rubick. I feel like it was just a free kill after he blinked in. But he stole the Winter's Curse.
Oh, I didn't see anything, bro. I was just being focused on my play-by-play. You know?
Dude, it's tough. It's tough.
It's really tough. It's
I feel you. They're getting the tier 2 tower, probably just falling back, waiting for the next DP ult, who now at the plate man is a lot more tanky. Gyrocopter, Scotty, and Aegis seems pretty much unkillable at this point, unless he's like the last man standing. This Wraith King item build, I feel like it's a lot less scaling than the Radiance. Like, Radiance just feels like it scales better.
Radiance is always good. The miss chance, overtime damage, you know that you have two lives, so there's going to be... Like, I just want to see some Radiance damage. How much damage you actually deal, let's say, with a Raid King in a team fight should be, like, around 2,000.
A couple of thousand,
yeah. Yeah.
Just by standing there. Like, you don't do anything, you respawn, you burn them again. It just... It's the best item on Wraith King, in my opinion, pretty much every game. Also helps you far much faster. He's 3k Nepo behind the Gyrocopter now, and I imagine it only gets bigger from this point on.
It's daytime now. Also, Night Stalker decided to get Aghanim Scepter before that Nullifier. So yeah, Void, like, it gives him an ability to scale. It's very annoying to play into. So far, TZY has been amazing on the Night Stalker, besides that like one disconnect from the team where he went in a bit too soon. Pretty much having a perfect game.
Yeah, Rocket on the Wraith King here, but should be alright. Do you like this MKB build-up on a Gyro? I feel like Butterfly would be so much better. Smoke in, hold that thought. Nightstalker smoke in, Rubick blink in. Getting focused on Rubick here. He has Winter's Curse stolen, but he just dies in one hit. Centaur in trouble, defensive Astro, but now Odie's in trouble. He has no way to get out of there. Wraith King alone versus Ford is not how where you want to be. Centaur will pop defensively, but it doesn't matter. Respawn on the Wraith King, but he's just gonna get taken out. Scotty keeps him. He's DPing out though. Is there any?
No, nope. They can't stop it. They have nothing. And Night Stalker, he's still chasing. TZY, man, he is my MVP for this match so far. Like, his blinks into silences have been amazing. But you know, you can also talk about the LBZS because they've been grouped up so much. So yeah, I want to see that again because you know, I've been focused on also what you're saying. There's some room for improvement in your play-by-play, I gotta say, but doing a decent job.
Thank you, I appreciate it. Why do you think the Night Stalker went for the Disruptor rather than killing the Wraith King? Because that seems like a much more value kill. We see here
maybe
in the replay...
Maybe he thought, like, we have him, like...
Look at the damage from Wraith King. BAM! Right in his forehead.
Gets him in pretty much one hit.
Defensive Astro, like, Odie just doesn't seem tanky at all during this BKB. Does absolutely nothing. Wraith King gets taken out alone. Centaur tries to save him with his ult, but... He just dies, and he can't fight into the Gyrocopter, but just TP's out. Just TP out.
Sometimes it is that easy. TP out.
And live.
Witchblade Vibernet. This one's really not paying off.
Yeah. Also, I don't know, I just feel there's no damage anymore.
And now they go on Winter
Vibernet. Exorcism. Yeah.
BKB pop, but the Astral from the OD will keep him alive. BKB will be out. Viper needs to be careful. It's daytime.
DP, no BKB available. Gonna get focused here by the OD with the BKB up. A defensive Astral once more. Night Stalker in the back line. DP still in trouble. Getting mech'd up, taking no damage from an Astral. Night Stalker still on the Winter Wyvern. Winter Wyvern dead. First life gone. No, defensive Astral once more. But this time he's really 1 versus 5, and there's no way to help him. He blinks out. Night Stalker ult popped in the back line. Winter Wyvern bought back, just to die again. Nope, he curses the Night Stalker. Wraith King already died, and they're gonna chase.
Oh, that cast range, nice. Etherlands, plus the talent, plus the his passive is just insane on Rubick.
Yep.
I think they're making a mistake where OD pops a BKB, Wraith King uses his BKB, they use Astral, and everyone's just standing around the Astral. Your BKB's gone during that time.
Yep, and OD just gets beaten up during his BKB. He has like zero impact. He used Sanity's Eclipse. It didn't deal any damage to anyone, really. At this point, he's just too under farmed. People say Odie is really broken, but not if you're dead on the farm, you do nothing.
Now he lost his lane pretty hard, and yeah, another they're going in once again.
And just dead.
Disruptor straight up dead.
No buyback on him as well. And I think they're probably just feeling good enough to get Mega Creeps, or at least two sites here. Crimson Guard to slow down a little bit.
Is available in a minute and 10 seconds. Dead Prophet ulti in 50. They still have time. They can rotate to the mid lane. Crimson Guard keeping it alive for a bit longer, but still not enough. Shylock on his Gyrocopter.
Finished MKB.
Finished that MKB, going into Satanic. Satanic doesn't give you any status resistance anymore. Gives you more damage, but yeah, still feels a very good item. Tanking up so you can't get blown up. Shylock pretty much having a perfect game, you know. IO, Gyro, still a viable combination. There's also double damage to be picked up now. He didn't die on Gyro a single time this game.
Yep, and he's bottling up that DD. Probably just waiting for the Roshan at this point, to be honest. And Dire is forced to fight into a Roshan fight. And what do we need, like, for LBZS to happen to win? Like, a really big curse, or...?
Like, these two supports, they're not scaling compared to what IO and Rubick are doing. It's very tough for them to fight into BKBs. Like, Disruptor Static Storm is not pretty much doing anything. You need to try to kite, possibly, with the Astral and then go in. What is Raking building? He's
AC.
Just getting... No, it's Moonshard.
Oh, it's a Moonshard. Interesting. Usually you just see that minus armor and survivability, because he doesn't have much armor himself.
Yeah, like his attack speed is also not the greatest, so I can't understand why. OD, he's
Cold Embrace, and he just dies during the Cold Embrace. Maybe he sabotaged him there a little bit.
A little bit? I'd call that too much, because they have still a ton of magical damage. Cooldown, Rocket Barrage.
Another Astro from the down.
From the downtown. Like down.
Wraith King blinking in. Trying to kill the Rubick. Rubick still running away. Center ult popped. Rubick, one more hit.
Glimpse back. Shylock is godlike. And TZY is beyond godlike. When you see that, you have to run. You know what I say? When it's time to call it,
it's time to call it.
Because this one's looking pretty over. Full team wipe.
Can't even kill the Rubick on that Wraith King.
Man, Rubick cast range is just insane.
He was downhill there, and he casted all the way up to the creep camp. That is crazy. Absolutely crazy.
It's insane. Good job, analysts, with the prediction. 0 and 5.
Well done, MagMA. Proving MagMA. All of us wrong.
Yeah, Shylock and the TZY, they played extremely well this game. Prolonged team fights.